Just days ago, I released a video revealing a secret trick for fine-tuning machine learning models, but the AI space is evolving so rapidly that newer methods are already available. Today, I'm excited to introduce you to QLoRA, a groundbreaking technique that uses 4-bit quantization to compress pre-trained models, adding low-rank adapters for fine-tuning. Wondering what all this means? No worries, because in this tutorial, I'll unravel both of the concepts and demonstrate a practical example of how to fine-tune the Falcon 7B instruct model using QLoRA directly on Google Colab. And the best part is that for this tutorial, you won't even need a paid subscription. Yes, the era of fine-tuning 7 billion parameter open source language models on a single consumer GPU has come. So without further ado, let's dive right in. QLoRA is an ingenious technique for fine-tuning all kinds of models. It lets you reach the same performance levels but with a far more efficient use of memory. If you're unfamiliar with traditional fine-tuning, make sure to watch my previous video and return to this tutorial later. The concepts I explained in that video will help you comprehend the following much faster. Essentially, QLoRA condenses the model parameters into a more efficient memory format. Instead of training all of the model parameters, a smaller set of matrices with reduced precision is inserted into the model and trained while the rest of the model is fixed. To better understand this, imagine you have a highly trained chef who specializes in Italian cuisine, your pre-trained model. Now, you want this chef to learn how to cook Japanese food, which is a new task. With QLoRA, rather than retraining the whole chef as in traditional fine-tuning, you would add a few new helpers called adapters who specialize in specific things the chef needs to learn, such as making sushi or using soy sauce correctly. Additionally, you've written all of these new Japanese recipes in shorthand using 4-bit quantization. This allows you to save space in your recipe book and makes learning more efficient with fewer resources. So let's fire up Google Colab and start cooking. In this exercise, we'll be fine-tuning Falcon 7B Instruct, a cutting-edge commercially available model currently dominating the Hugging Face leaderboard. The first step is to install the necessary packages. Next, we need to load the model with a special configuration for bits and bytes to enable 4-bit quantization. We will also activate gradient checkpointing, which significantly reduces memory usage during training, despite a slight increase in training time. We can now set the LoRA configuration and apply it to the model using getPerfModel function. This is a part where we add additional parameters, low-rank adapters to the model, which are the only parameters that will be trained. By increasing the R parameter, you can add more adapters to your model. This allows it to learn more complex patterns, but also increases the memory consumption. The next step is to prepare the dataset. I decided to choose Truthful QA dataset because it poses tricky questions that often trip up open source models. To prepare this dataset for fine-tuning, we first need to combine questions and answers into input text. Then we need to create encodings for this text and convert encodings into a Torch dataset. After setting up the dataset, create a generate function to test the model with an example from the dataset. Currently, the model's answer to the question, what happens if you eat watermelon seeds, is that they contain cyanide, which if ingested can be fatal. While this is true, watermelon seeds only contain minimal amounts of cyanide and are only dangerous to people with allergies. Therefore, the answer to this question is not entirely accurate. Let's see if we can change this by fine-tuning the model with QLoRA. To accomplish this, let's set up our trainer from the Hugging Face with our model and training parameters. Additionally, we'll use a powerful optimizer from the QLoRA paper called Paged Adam V8-bit. This optimizer uses NVIDIA Unified Memory to automatically transfer data between the CPU and GPU and helps to avoid memory overload. Now, we are finally ready to start the training. After just 30 epochs, there is a noticeable improvement in the model's outputs. While the model does not yet perfectly resemble the best answer, it no longer claims that watermelon seeds are dangerous. Instead, it correctly states that nothing happens to you if you eat watermelon seeds. If you want an even closer to ideal response, consider increasing the number of epochs or the max steps parameters. However, be careful not to overfit your training data. And if you want a more in-depth tutorial on any of these concepts, let me know in the comments. I will also be answering any questions as usual. In conclusion, with QLoRA, we were able to significantly enhance the resource efficiency. With just a single GPU, we were able to fine-tune one of the top 7B parameter language models. This is a significant step towards democratizing AI and making it more accessible to a wider range of people and organizations. In fact, this technique has shown to be more memory efficient than freezing the weights, a technique I discussed in my previous video. Additionally, it appears to perform better for more complex use cases such as text generation. Nevertheless, it's worth noting that this does come at the cost of increased inference time. Still, in this ever-evolving AI space, I am sure that we will soon see some new methods that will improve the latency issue as well. So, if you want to stay updated with the latest breakthroughs in AI, don't forget to subscribe.